see, Ellie is like trying to help out Henry.
They're gonna be fine.
Yeah, yeah, I know.
All right, come on, kid. See if we can find a way out of here, yeah?
Okay.
Okay.
Ugh, this sucks. Give me a brick.
Did you see that?
Stay behind me. If I run, you run.
Yeah.
God damn it. God. Oh. I'm toast. Really aggressive, man. Making a run for it. I'm making a fucking run for it. Fuck that, man.
Move it.
Come on. Run. Oh my God. Oh fuck. I guess I gotta go this way. Did I just come from there? No, I didn't. Okay. Oh, what's that? I'm gonna get that.
Here, give me a boost.
Oh, fuck.
I can get through that window.
Oh, this part,
open,
man.
It from the other side.
This
Make
part sucks.
Come on, Sam. You're not staying in here.
What about you?
I'll be fine. Come on, go.
This part sucks.
Get ready.
Let's go.
Oh my God, there's two of them. There's fucking two of them. And I can't fucking move. kidding? He fucking disarmed my trap, man. I'll wait until the second wind to do that. Damn you, naughty dog. Damn you. I'm just kidding. It was my own retardation.
Oh, are you fucking kidding me? Thanks for the warning on the other side, guys.
So where's this tower? We're close. Come on, let's go. Hey.
Man, the only reason they kept coming is because they were never supposed to stop. I'm so stupid.
We made it out. Yeah.
Hey, look at that. Yep. What'd I tell you, huh?
Let's find a way around to it.
What about you? How you holding up?
Business as usual, right? When I was with Henry, I took out a couple of infected by myself. You'd be proud.
Yeah.
Let's go explore these houses and get some loot.
It was pretty intense back there, huh?
Oh, yeah. Totally.
How did you two end up together?
Oh, a friend of mine, Marlene, asked him to take me to the Fireflies.
You seem to get along well.
Yeah, well, now I just boss him around. Isn't that right, Joel?
There we go. That'll help a lot.
What was this place like without infected? I can't even imagine it.
Nice. Okay. Probably got some stuff down here. Got some alcohol. I don't know what else. Go upstairs. It might take me a while to get down, relaxed from that. gosh. It's brutal. It's brutal when you, realize that you messed up, man. Anyways. Looks like someone kind of lived here for a bit. I mean, after the outbreak. I don't know. If I lived in this kind of world, I don't think I would survive long. Mostly because I wouldn't really have much of a reason to survive. I mean, you're just surviving for the sake of survival. Now, I guess the point of this game, though, is that you need
just
more.
Five when the cordyceps hit. My memory's pretty hazy, but I remember living in a neighborhood just like this.
What do you remember?
Barbecues. Parents, they would throw these crazy big barbecues, invite a ton of people. You know, I remember the smell more than anything. Weird.
That's not weird. Your sense of smell is the sense most connected to memory. It's really not weird. Oh! Make some barbecue right here! Yeah, it's interesting is that in the last, like, couple of years, maybe the last decade, the whole zombie apocalypse thing has gotten really, it's just kind of blown up. And, you know, we were talking about this in one of my literature classes, how trends kind of pop up during specific historical events. I think one of the biggest things that influenced this...
Hey, you want to stay away from those. It's not like it is in the zone. These are wild.
One of the biggest things that influenced the, you know, I've read some articles and stuff on this, but I think the biggest thing that influenced the whole zombie theme, well, obviously, the infected are different than zombies, of course. Don't give me hate in the comment section about that. I know that, but it's inspired by
this?
That theme.
Oh.
It's an upgrade of the theme.
Ice cream truck?
Yeah, Henry told me about these. They sell ice cream out of the truck.
What? No way, Joel.
That's true. This thing drive around and play real loud, creepy music, and kids would come running out to buy ice cream.
You're totally fucking with me.
Mm-mm, serious.
Man, you lived in a strange time.
Told you so.
Yeah, so, two of the biggest things that really influence this theme is, well, September 11th, obviously, because that kind of wrecked our generation's view of, like, I mean, not only that, it was like September 11th happened, and then all of these natural disasters happened, and it's like, this theme of the end of the world became really popular because of a lot of the, because before that, and especially in America, there was just like economic boom, and that's the second thing that really influenced this theme is the biggest themes was definitely the crash of the economy in the early 2000s. Like, that brought a lot of people that were in upper middle class to lower middle class or even lower, including myself. And that, I feel like some of the theme of struggling to provide for your family and the uncertainty of the future was something that we're all really familiar with. And I think that's, it's interesting to see, you look back on, I really love like 1940s, 1950s cinema, and you look back on some of the themes of those times, Invasion of the Body Snatchers is about, it's all about paranoia of that is related to the 1940s and 1950s, and World War II, the transition from World War II to the Cold War, and that constant fear of being watched by other countries, something that prevailed for a very long time. That was something that people were afraid of in that time. Now, sure, we're not necessarily afraid of the world ending, but life is life for many people, especially in America, has just changed. You know, a lot of the things that I grew up with, I don't experience anymore. I don't know what it's like to have everything handed to me in the same way I did when I was a kid. And I think that's mostly because of the change of the economy. Oh, cool. I never noticed that.
Shit. You alright?
Yeah. Ceiling's falling apart.
Huh. I've never noticed this before. I mean, I may be rambling, and maybe my history is a little bit off, but I think, you know, you can correct me and correct my references if you want. I'm not planning this discussion. It's just kind of happened. Oh.
Thank you.
Wow. That's cool. Wow. I've never seen that, but I guess you just get a melee upgrade out of it. And I guarantee you, the reason why, like, superhero stories, for instance, have to change is because they have to evolve with the times. Things, look at the old Superman movies, they seem cheesy to us now. I look at the old Batman movies, I mean, well, some of them are classics, but some of them, they just were bad. I mean, Batman and Robin was bad, but it seems even worse compared to Nolan's films. And the reason why Nolan was successful is because he latched on to a paranoia that was so prevalent for us at the time.
Get out!
Fucking sniper. Did you see where it came from?
Somewhere down the street. Right now. Y'all stay here.
No!
Before you start, I need you guys to keep him busy. I'm gonna go around and see if I can't get the angle on him.
Okay. Hey. Be careful.
God damn it. Fuck. I'm gonna have to do this again, ain't I? God damn it. Well, I thought I could cut through here, but I guess I can't. I'm so over this, man. I'm so fucking over this.
Get him, boys! Show those cute faces again! Get him, boys! Where'd you go, you fucking shit?
That's not gonna work.
Son of a bitch! Oh, shit!
got, kid? Where'd you go?
Go check out the dirt. You guys, go check over that way.
If we go through this way, it's definitely gonna make noise.
Holy shit!
Oh my god, I thought this was the one. Of all times to not have a health kit, this is the worst. Where is he? Am I in the wrong fucking house? No, I'm not. Oh god. Oh god. Damn. This part, man. Damn it, Bert. Okay.
Come on, guys.
Uh-oh. Oh, fuck. Ah, come on. Ah, this part, man. There's no way I can take it out, man.
Don't get away from us, huh? We're back, motherfucker! Come on, run! Come on. Come on.
Burn, asshole!
God damn it.
Sweet Jesus.
You're gonna make me have to redo that whole thing just because I didn't.
You all right, Sam?
Yeah, I'm okay.
Thanks, Joel.
Look at this.
All right. We did
it. Seth, there's clickers coming.
We should move.
All right. Sam!
Henry!
Sam, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
You sure?
I said I'm fine.
Come on!
Let's move!
Hurry up. Damn. Yeah, I don't know. They go too fast, man. I can't. They're too damn fast.
No.
Oh, God. Yeah, it's time to run, man.
You're okay.
Still in here. Anybody hurt?
Uh-oh.
No, we're good. I think it's time we quit this place. Come on.
Let's go.
Shut the hell up.
Dead serious. It was Tommy's birthday, and that's all he wanted to do is just rent two Harleys and drive cross country.
I could die happy if I could just ride one around the block. What was it like?
It was good. It was real good.
Good? Can you believe this guy? Come on, man, give me details. Describe it.
You know what? You two deserve a little privacy.
No, Ellie. This isn't just any regular motorcycle, okay? You get on that bad boy, you feel that engine? Nothing like it.
Oh, yeah? How would you know?
Seen it in my dreams.
Okay.
I don't think anyone from my group is gonna show up.
Yeah.
Worst part about it all, explaining it to Sam.
Well, it's safe to say those two have officially bonded. What are you doing?
Taking stock of all the food we found today.
I see. And how are we doing on canned peaches?
Did Henry send you?
No. Why would Henry send me?
To make sure I'm not fucking up somehow.
I'd say we all did pretty good back there. Especially you. Is everything all right?
Yeah, everything's fine.
Okay. Well, have a good night.
How is it that you're never scared?
Who says that I'm not?
What are you scared of?
Let's see. scorpions are pretty creepy. Being by myself. I'm scared of ending up alone. What about you?
Those things out there. What if the people are still inside? What if they're trapped in there without any control of their body? I'm scared of that happening to me.
Okay. First of all, we're a team now. Okay, we're gonna help each other out. And second, they might still look like people, but that person is not in there anymore.
Henry says that they've moved on, that they're with their families, like in heaven. Do you think that's true?
I go back and forth. I mean, I'd like to believe it.
But you don't.
I guess not.
Yeah, me neither.
Oh, all the serious talk. I almost forgot.
There. Oh.
If he doesn't know about it, he can't take it away. All right, I'm pooped. I'll see you tomorrow.
Man.
Damn. That smells good.
Good morning.
Where's Sam?
I let him sleep in for once.
Oh.
Well, if you want him to join us, you can go wake his ass up.
Okay. Sam? Sam!
The hell? Shit, he's turning! That's my fucking brother! Screw it!
Shit!
Really? Gotta go, you're right.
Oh my god.
Sam?
Oh no.
Sam?
Henry? Ellie, stay there. Henry?
What have you done?
I'm gonna get that gun from you, okay? Oh, okay, easy.
It's your fault.
This is nobody's fault, Henry.
It's all your fault!
Henry! Henry, no!
Whoa. The crazy thing is, the first time I saw this part, I did not see that coming whatsoever. I have to say, the way that was executed was perfect. The editing was perfect. It's so sudden. The cut happens right after the suicide, and you just have nothing but darkness, and that just lets it really soak in. I think that that's the editing of this game is incredible, but in that scene, what really made it amazing was not only the acting, but just the director's choice to cut it off at that very moment, and not linger on it. You know, you go directly to fall right after that. And I think that says something about this game, is that you don't get time to mourn. You have to keep going. Sam and Henry's relationship was really supposed to mirror that of Ellie and Joel, and it's supposed to remind us of what Joel is willing to do to protect Ellie and what Ellie is willing to do to protect Joel, but also how vulnerable caring for someone is in this world, and that Joel's desire to be isolated and not have any emotional connections is very valid. Like, the way that he approaches relationships in this world is very valid. It's a very valid way to approach things, because the thing is, one of them is going to die eventually, you know? That's just how life works. And I'm not spoiling anything of the plot or anything. I'm just saying, like, in this world, it would be impossible for both of them to survive and live a long life. I mean, the fact that Joel is still alive at his age, which isn't that old, is amazing. The fact that Ellie's alive is amazing. Things are not going to end well at some point, because that is the world that this is, you know? Like, Sam and Henry's story was important because it made that theme of loss so real to the game. You know, you hear about people dying, and yes, both Ellie and Joel have lost someone, but Sam and Henry's death just kind of reminds you that sense of loss will never end in this world. Like, you can never be secure and dream of a happily ever after. There's no happy ever after in this world. There's only continual survival. You have to live from moment to moment. And there's so much more that I could say about this scene. And I'd love to hear your interpretation. But I think the biggest thing about every interaction that you have with different characters in this story is that it proves the character development of Ellie and Joel. And every character kind of represents a way that Ellie and Joel's relationship could end. Sam and Henry represents Joel's hesitancy to get close to anyone. They solidify the fact that everyone dies horrifically in this world. There are so few natural deaths in this universe, you know, of this game. And Bill represented the fact that if you accept that fact too much, you'll have missed opportunities. So it's like, either way you lose. I mean, because if you shut people out like Bill did, then you'll never get the opportunity to have relationships. But if you appreciate and love the people in your life, that during the time they're in your life, you may end up like Sam and Henry. And that was so messed up. Like, the acting, incredible. You know, you just sense the instability of Henry when he kills his brother is dead, and that split second decision to end his own life. Yeah, the acting, the editing, so incredible, so spot on. Thank you. I would love to have some of my professors of film watch this game and just admire that that editing right there. Perfect. The timing was perfect. So tragic. But now we go on to fall.